talk about your personal experience with the phrase, "That's so gay."
Well, as a teacher, I never really ran into the problem in the classroom. But as a student, I do remember hearing it frequently in high school and not thinking much about it. But now I'm aware, you know, of exactly what it means, and doing research and stuff on it, you know, I've formed a different opinion.
Well, as a teacher during the practicum, I came across it a lot. Usually it was towards male students, and it was usually because of their actions, and I'm not quite sure if they understood if, like, what they meant really by it when they said it. But it always had a negative connotation, and the male students that used it more aggressively than the females did, and the females did more playfully. But either way, it wasn't used in a positive sense.
Either as a teacher or as a student yourself, talk about your experiences with the phrase, "That's so gay."
So when I was thinking about times I've heard the phrase, "That's so gay," one memory that stuck out in my head was during my high school experience. I went to a high school that was an arts high school, and I took dance, and there was a boy that I was friends with, a dancer, who hadn't come out as being gay yet. He has since come out, but back when we were taking dance together, he wasn't out yet. And I just remember walking down the halls and just kind of the strange, you know, glances and whispers that people that would be talking about him, A, because he was a dancer, B, because he also did appear pretty feminine, and definitely. And usually the phrase, "That's so gay," would happen at, like, somebody approaching me to ask me if he what, or, like, saying, like, "Oh, that's so gay that he's in dance," but they would never really say it directly to him. But, I don't know, it was always kind of a touchy subject for me. I never really knew what to say, so it's kind of interesting. And, as a teacher at my elementary school, it wasn't so much of an issue, although I could see how some of my ESL students who are kind of still in the machismo kind of state of mind would use that phrase to talk about their friends, their male friends that did anything that was remotely feminine at all. So
I didn't hear it so much as a student teacher. In fact, it was noticeably absent, if you ask me. It's just maybe a product of the school I was at. It seemed very aware, seemed very sensitive to the issue. But as a student myself, in middle school and even high school, I grew up in northern New England, and, I mean, everything was so gay, or just wicked gay dude, and, I mean, it was really everywhere. And the thing is, I don't think that the connection between sexuality or sexual orientation and the word was ever consciously or unconsciously in anybody's mind. It was sort of this disconnect.
You know, I heard "That's so gay" all the time as a student. I remember hearing it in the classroom, you know, probably starting around middle school and slowed down a little bit in high school. And then as a teacher, I encountered it all the time in my classes. And typically I would ask the student, "What did you mean by that? Is that really what you're trying to say? Is that person really gay?" Because I feel like as an English teacher, I should promote the time in my classes. And typically I would ask the student, "What did you mean by that? Is that really what you're trying to say?"